In this chapter, you will study about the Earth system and learn about Earth's spheres. Historically, students have studied four spheres: the geosphere, biosphere, atmosphere, and hydrosphere. In this presentation, you will learn about a fifth sphere, the cryosphere. The geosphere is the Earth itself, all of the physical features of the planet except water. It is the portion of Earth's system that includes Earth's interior and exterior, rocks and minerals, landforms, and the processes that shape the surface. It is not a perfect sphere. Rather, it is an oblate spheroid, similar to the shape of a football. Sir Isaac Newton, a 17th century scientist, predicted a similar shape prior to the advancement of instruments and spacecraft. His predictions were based on the effects of Earth's daily rotation and studies of other planets. Geodesy, the study of Earth's shape, is a very important science. It helps us understand satellite orbits, create maps, and navigate the planet using devices such as a GPS. Geosphere is also referred to as lithosphere, or land. The biosphere is the biological component of Earth's systems, including all living organisms on Earth together with the dead organic matter produced by them. It is made up of all that is living on Earth, including between 3 and 30 million species of plants, animals, and fungi, and two kinds of single-celled living things, those with nuclei and those without nuclei. The biosphere extends over the Earth's surface in a thin layer, from a few kilometers into the atmosphere to the deep sea vents of the ocean depths. The biosphere is a life-supporting global ecosystem where each living thing depends on each other and the environment. It includes all biotic organisms and abiotic environment on which they depend for their energy and the nutrients they need to live. The atmosphere is an envelope of gas that surrounds the Earth and extends thousands of kilometers out from Earth's surface. The atmosphere has five primary layers that are, from lowest to highest, the troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. We will study these layers in a later presentation. The atmosphere contains the air we breathe, the wind that blows through our hair, the clouds that float in the sky, and all the weather that takes place. It surrounds us at every moment and keeps us alive and warm. The important properties of the atmosphere are the temperature, how cold or hot the air is, the pressure, how thick or dense the air is, and the humidity, how much water is in the air. The hydrosphere is the collective mass of water found on, under, and over Earth's surface. It is the liquid water component of the Earth. It includes oceans, seas, lakes, ponds, rivers, and streams. The hydrosphere covers about 70% of Earth's surface and is home for many plants and animals. It is always in motion. It is affected by temperature and salinity, or salt content. Warm water is less dense and lighter, therefore it moves toward the surface. Cold water is more dense and heavier, therefore it sinks toward the bottom. Salty water is also more dense and sinks toward the bottom. The oceans of the hydrosphere serve two main purposes: as large reservoirs for chemicals, and to redistribute energy received from the sun. The cryosphere, or the frozen water part of the Earth's system, includes continental or land ice, such as the continental ice sheets of Greenland, Antarctica, China, and South America, and valley glaciers that cover every continent except Australia. It is formed from the accumulation of snow at the surface that compresses over time under the weight of the snow. It includes sea ice, or frozen seawater, such as that on the Arctic Ocean, oceans surrounding Antarctica, and frozen lake or river water. It is formed by the direct freezing of water on which it floats. The cryosphere is considered part of the hydrosphere. When scientists talk about the cryosphere, they mean places where water is in its solid form, as snow or ice.